that they have a third brother who happens to be black. The mother really got her out.
Right.
The third brother happens to be Jimmy Walker, who plays the black brother of the three.
Mr. Dynamite.
And in the picture finishes with a Chinese brother who happens to come in and say, oh, hello, brother, like right here. And it's the fourth brother. And this is a whole comedy about these four brothers trying to run a funeral party.
If you're in it, I want to go and see it. I happen to be...
is going to be a phenomenal hit picture.
My enthusiasm registers with the audience. It always generates with the audience. I happen to be a fan of Jackie Mason. The only time in my life I ever hurt my back laughing and had to walk out. I think I was a kid, you were a kid, but you were doing a routine
at the Concord Hotel.
I don't know where it was.
It was the Concord, the Jewish Mountains.
And you, I forget. I don't think I was
in the Catskills, the Concord Hotel.
One of those, some hotel somewhere. I was a kid.
I'm coming back there again Labor Day, but right now.
And you were doing the routine of James Cagney in a synagogue,
right.
And Sammy Davis in a synagogue, right. And Jimmy Stewart as they would perform on the holy days in a synagogue. It was just.
It was just amazingly brilliant. I can't get over how great it was. And thank God we kept that quiet, too. But it's an amazing thing with my picture career.
Yes.
I made that picture, the story that you're talking about 12 years ago, that
right.
wasn't such a sensational hit.
Right.
But then I made a picture called Tight Jeans with Karen Black.
Right.
That's coming out in October.
Right.
And it's already a sensation.
Jeans or Karen Black?
And now I'm making this comedy. I just finished the Stiffs. Now I'm making another picture about the Ku Klux Klan. A comedy about the Ku Klux Klan versus Goldberg.
That'll be a smash.
About one Jew who fights the whole Ku Klux Klan and wipes them out.
Why don't you do a TV talk
show? Before I get wiped out, I want to talk fast and get off the stage.
Why don't you do a TV talk show?
Because as soon as they hear about this picture, I haven't got long to last myself.
Why don't you do an interview show like this?
I happen to love these interview shows because it gives you an opportunity to ask very intelligent questions that nobody understands. And doesn't make too much
sense. Jack, I got a young lady coming up today named Lisa Brandy, wants to be your opening act. Are you at Dangerfields now?
I'm at Dangerfields now, and every show is not only busy, jammed, you can't get in. Luckily, I have room for one more person if you happen to be listening. Unless you have a friend, we'll have find room for two. If you have a crowd that's not busy, we'll find room for them too. But the place is packed every night. We have two shows a night, and you can't get into either one of them. Unless you've got time, we'll find place for you.
This is a busy, busy man. I'm going to let him go back to work, but I got to ask you, Jackie, help me analyze some of the older ones. George Burns. Bob Hope. What's the secret is it venerability that...
I think it's hard work. I have found that all these comedians will last a long lifetime.
Right.
And are still on top of the heap 30 years later, 50, 60 years later.
Yes.
All have one thing in common. They work terribly hard on material and ideas, and they're fresh with their thoughts and their awareness of what's going on today as they were 50 years ago. Bob Hope has the same agility mentally and the same involvement in what's happening. And is just as bright and as hip with what's happening in the news
right.
today. He's as hot as today's newspaper. Every single day, he makes sure he makes a total study and a coverage of everything going on every
but
place
Jackie,
in the world.
One thing.
And immediately has comments and has opinions and all kinds of satirical ideas about everything that's happening.
One thing about Jackie Mason, and I guess I've said it before, but not in the last few years, you are so original. I've never seen you do any joke, per se, that anybody ever said you...
Because I find that jokes are the same stale formula that everybody
right.
does.
Right.
If you haven't got something original to bring to this business,
right.
if you have nothing new to offer, then people will never get excited about you. All stars have one thing in common. They're identifiable as a personality. They have something different and special and unique, and people recognize the difference in them.
I've got a man going to give out $25,000.
And that's
right
why
now.
You have nothing to worry about. You're certainly different. You certainly, not many people your talent have the knife to show up. Not many people your talent have a knife to call themselves this a show. An empty building with a hog at the furniture. There's about $1.25 invested in this whole thing.
My future is a thing of the past. You know why people
even
like
these couches were sold long time
you know
ago.
People, like me,
from the Salvation Army.
I got that certain nothing. If you want to have a good time,
do you want me to tell you the truth? Everybody watches you because they don't know how you got the job. And I notice, that they love you because they don't know what you do for a living, and they're thrilled about it. I can't get over the fact that I had nothing to do but come over here, which goes to show you how good I'm doing.
And I'm good to my family. I never go home at night. Right? Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank Jackie. I want to go to see myself at Dangerfield. I'll carry on with some exciting people. We're going to go into the...
Why do you try to tell me there's a difference between me and the exciting people you have to come on?
We're going to go into the video.
Is he just trying to say that there's a difference between me and the real guests that he has coming on? He has this girl, Lisa, who's a stunning young lady. And I heard she's a phenomenal singer. She's the daughter of one of the DeMarco sisters.
I think so, yes.
Who themselves were not so fantastic. But the main thing is they were working. They were working. Not when they were in show business. When they got out of the business, they were so busy you couldn't get enough of them.
Ladies and gentlemen.
That's what I love about the DeBacco sisters. Four of them had to get together to sing one song.
Five
had to get together.
We shall return.
And after five got together, everybody said, what are they singing about? When five people are singing together, you don't hear a word. So they were a hit.
Jackie, if Ed Sullivan were here right now, how would he say we're going?
If Ed Sullivan were here right now, he would say, next, I heard enough of this guy. I'll let give up. Let's get back to Joe Franklin, because you are truly a sensation. There's a lot of people with talent who make a living without it. This is the trick. God bless you. Let's hope you have many more years of whatever it is you're doing now that I'll never live to figure out.
At least two more weeks. Jackie
Take
Mason,
care of yourself.
One of my very favorite people. And a standing ovation for
a standing ovation.
Terrific guy. We love him.